Welcome back with the next chapter 11, Work and Energy. About the chapter. In the previous chapter, we have been discussing about the motion of the object and their cause of motion and gravitation. In this chapter, we are going to learn about another concept which will help us to understand many natural phenomena is work. And all living beings need to take food because all of them have to perform several activities to live. These activities are known as life process, and this process require energy which comes from food, and the requirement of energy depend upon the type of work. Work. From our daily life experience, it can be said that work and energy are interconvertible to each other. For example, all our daily life activities such as playing, walking, cycling, writing, jumping and thinking, etc. requires energy which is obtained from the food that we consume. Similarly, all the machines and engines need a fuel like diesel or petrol to work. There is difference in the way we use the term work in day-to-day life and the way we use it in science. For example, Kamali is preparing for examination. She spends a lot of time to study. She reads books, practices diagrams, organizes her thoughts, discusses the problem with her friends. She expends a lot of energy in performing these activities. In common parlance, she is working hard. All this hard work involves many little work. If we go by the scientific definition of work, you stand still for a few minutes with a heavy load on your head. You get tired. You have exerted yourself and have spent quite a bit of energy. Are you doing work on the load? The way we understand the term work in science, work is not done. Work done by a constant force. The physical meaning of the term work is different from what it means in the daily life. For example, a student learning his lesson, a person standing with a load kept on his head, and even a teacher teaching in a class, all are not doing any work. Scientific conception of work is that in physics, work is said to be done when the force applied on the body displays its position in the direction of the applied force. So it is clear that for work to be done, the following two conditions need to be satisfied. First one, the force should act on the body, and the second one, the body must be displaced from its position. To understand this, we shall first consider the case when the force is acting on the direction of displacement. Let a constant force F act on one direction. Let the object be displaced through a distance. S is the direction of the force. Let W be the work done. We define work to be equal to the product of the force and displacement. That means work done is equal to force into displacement. SI unit of work. Work, we know that it is a scalar quantity, that is, it has only magnitude but no direction. The SI unit of work is Newton meter or joule. Thus, 1 joule is the amount of work done on an object when the force of 1 Newton displaces the object through 1 meter along the line of the action of the force. Next, the nature of the work done. Work done by the force when the direction of the force subtends an angle theta with the direction of displacement is given by work done is equal to Fs cos theta. Work done by the force acting on a body can be positive, zero or negative depending on the direction of the displacement. First, the positive work done. If the force applied to the body and the displacement of the body are in the same direction, then the work done by the force is called positive work done. Second is that zero work done. If the force applied to the body and the displacement of the body are perpendicular to each other, then the work done by the force is called as zero work done. Next is the negative work done. If the force applied to the body and the displacement of the body is in opposite direction to that the force applied, then the work is called as negative work done. Energy. Life is impossible without energy. The demand of the energy is ever increasing. But where do we get energy from? The sun is the biggest source of energy to us. Many of our energy resources are derived from the sun. We can also get energy from the nuclei of atoms, the interior of the earth, and the tides. The word energy is often used in our daily life, but in science we give a definite and precise meaning. Energy of the body is defined as the capacity or the ability of the body to do a work. For doing work, energy is always consumed. When a body is capable of doing more work, it is said to be possess more energy and vice versa. The body doing the work loses energy while that on which the work is done gain energy. This is because energy is transferred from one body to the other while exerting a force. So work done against a force is stored in the form of energy. Example, a stamp is displaces from the stationary position when a fast moving cricket ball hits it. Energy is a scalar quantity, that is, it has only magnitude and no direction. Its SI unit is joule, same as that work. And the joule is the smaller unit of energy. The unit of the energy called joule is named after that a British physicist James Prescott Joule. And 1 joule energy is defined as the energy required to do 1 joule of work. And the largest unit of the energy is kilojoule. That means 1 kilojoule is equal to 1000 joule. Now we discuss about some examples of energy. Let us consider the following example. When a fast moving cricket ball hits a stationary wicket, the wicket is thrown away. When a race hammer falls on a nail placed on a piece of wood, it drives the nails into the wood. When a balloon filled with air is pressed, we see a change in the shape. However, if we press the balloon hard, it can even explode, producing a blasting sound.